everyone, in this tutorial I want to use a cam animation, and for this I am going under start, select assembly, give it name, and the work area appears. But before this I am going to show you that I have made a base. And on the front plane I have sketched a profile. A profile 100 top and 105 the dimension and 100 down, and I have the put a circle in the middle, and I have extruded with the extrude definition, edit definition, with 70 length. Later I have a sketch on top plane and a square, and I have draw a circle, and the distance between the center and the axis is 10. Uko, and the extrusion is 75 midpoint, means that 70 up total, and midpoint in the in each direction it is 37.5. Uko. Then I have designed a cam. I have sketched on the front view a circle with diameter 200 and a circle with diameter 100, and the distance between the upper circle to the axis is 100, and the distance between lower circle to axis is 100, and I connected those two circles via a line, and then I have chosen at the line to be tangents to circle, and I have selected the line and the circle, also selected the line and this circle, and I have trimmed the extra arc, and I have extruded edit definition V20, and then I have designed, added a circle, edit definition, we take 30 in diameter and in at the center of that arc, and I have extruded, edit definition, and I have extruded with 50, but I can change also till 75. Uko. And save it. Uko. And I have designed a follower. I have made a circle, edit definition, a circle with diameter 30 and extrusion length 200, and then I have sketched an square. I have sketched an square 40 by 40, sent the symmetry through the last circle, and I have extruded with 10 as length. Then I have selected that face, and I have sketched a rectangle through 60, and I have put a circle 15 degrees, and the distance between the circle and that edge is 20, and I have extruded also with 10, and at last I have mirrored that last extrusion. I have used round with those edges with the 20 as radius, and then I have select both extrude and round and mirror it through the front face plane. Okay, later I have made a roller. It is a sketch, edit definition, and it is 30 millimeter as diameter, and I have sketched another circle with 15 millimeter as diameter, and the first extrusion, edit definition, the first extrusion is 20 midpoint, 20 total, 10 there and 10 there, and then that extrude, I have made the extrusion by 20 length, and then I have mirrored through right plane. Now we start. We are going to use new and select assembly and call it cam or what you will, and then select OK to get and work area. Now I am going to add a part, and I am going to use base, and I deselect the planes, and I am going to select the part coordinate system to assembler coordinate system. OK, zoom all. Now I am going to use as a standard. Now I am going to add the cam open, and I am going to use pin and select that face and select that face as well. The connection is not complete. I select that face and that face. Now it is okay. We are going to use drag and select, and you see that it's rotating well. Okay, close. Now I am going to add the follower, and I am going to use slider and select that axis to that axis. And the connection is not complete. I am going to show the planes, and I am going to select the top plane of follower, the top plane, and I am going to select the right plane of base. Uko. And I am going to make a motion of this, and it is correct. Now I am going to add the ruler, and it is pin. Zoom in. Select that axis. Zoom all and zoom in. Select that axis and use that face to that face, and it is complete. Uko. I am going to snap that face and coming down, and it is correct. Uko, close. Now I am going to mechanism, and I am going to use cam, and I am going to use auto select and select that face, and all the faces are selected. Uko. And I am going to select the other cam and auto select and use deselect the coordinate system. That. Arc Uko, and we are going to select Uko. Now those parts are touching each other. Use a standard orientation, and I am going to make a servo motor. Type the motion axis, and it is that axis. And on the profile, I use velocity V20, apply Uko. Now I am going to analysis, and I use 100 V2 in ratio, run. Now you can see that our model works. Now I am going to use the front view, run, yes. And you see that it is correct. It has a space at the top. Okay, it was all in this tutorial. See you on next tutorial.